I don't really know how to do an intro for this video. I mean, look at that. It's insane. If you're familiar with Loop Hero, everything on screen should fascinate you, and I'm going to be breaking down every part of it for this video. How I got here, the deck I used, the items, what all of this means, because I mean, look at that. We have 35,000 completed resources. Nah, not 35,000 little ones, 35,000 big resources, which is insane. And as you watch, I just go around the map and I'm getting tons of items and everything is just kind of falling into place and it all works. I got enough villages going, I got enough road lanterns going, nothing spawning, and if you can just look at these numbers, they're also ridiculous. We have 7,800 loops. I've been AFKing this for days. Once I got it set up, I had the peace of mind. I could just walk away from the computer and effectively beat this game. Now I'm on Act 4. I haven't beaten the Act 4 boss, but I feel like all of this just really sets me up to get Loop Hero closed out and we're done there. So that's where we are right now with this, but I feel like it's time to wrap it up. I have other Loop Hero videos I need to make, and I've just been enjoying the game too much to actually go out and make the content, but now that I've accomplished what feels like perfection inside this game, we can continue on and then start doing some crazy stuff. So let's break down how I got here. Hopefully you were able to appreciate all of this madness, and it's time to put this to an end. So let's see what we got. Yeah, that's a lot of stuff. So there's no base camp resource cap. That was like my only worry, that this is going to stop at like 900 or maybe even 9,999. But nah, everything you get, you keep, as long as you're in Act 4, because that's an unlimited resource cap. So let's go to the deck. I've seen some infinite loop setups that are like very aggro heavy, that what you want to do is you want to overlevel, you want to scale up really quick, and then you start breaking it down from there and making it to where monsters don't spawn. I don't like that. I didn't find that to be super effective. So what I have is just things that are going to get me to the point where I'm collecting tons of resources and not having to worry about spawns. That's why we have ruins. Ruins, they give a random basic resource upon visit. Well, when you're at Act 4, you also get extra resources, so that's really nice to have. Villages, nothing spawns on villages, so it's effectively road lanterns and villages making to where it's impossible for any monster to spawn on the map. And it's just possible. If you have four road lanterns stacking on a single tile, nothing spawns there because the spawn limit is four. But road lanterns are going to be less efficient than villages. I think it takes eight road lanterns to make it to where five tiles will not have monsters spawning on them. So it's also about patterns. That what you need to do is you need to get the right map, and then you need to place everything perfectly, that way there's less chance of it going wrong, because if you don't get enough oblivions, if the boss spawns too early, if things get a little ugly, then it could ruin your entire run because you are playing on a knife's edge. But once you get it set up, then you're effectively set for life when it comes to resources. So villages are better because it's one village for one tile, but every two villages, bandit camp spawn, and that gets sketchy if you start running out of oblivions. And then I use spider cocoons because that just gives me a lot of card advantage. Kill the spiders, get cards, cycle them through bookeries, you're good to go. These don't matter. As you notice, I put like three rivers in a meadow, and it doesn't matter. As long as you're doing this quick and you're getting set up, good to go. Arsenal, I like it because that magic shield on the rogue is too good, and we are going to be running the rogue because, as you saw, you just get equipment shards. Even if you have no trophies, you still just get a full inventory worth of equipment shards. It's kind of ridiculous. So let's also go and check out my supply. This is the most important thing. So if you're in the early game, if you're still like Act 2, Act 3, and you're like trying to get going in this game, first off, check out the description. I already have an early resource guide, and more guides are on the way. This just kind of got in the way of making content for a bit because I've been AFKing for 3 days to get like infinite amount of resources. But exquisite mirrors. These might sound weird, like 6% chance to redirect lightning. Well, I'm not even using storm temples, and like 6% chance doesn't sound like anything. No, you need these because it redirects the lich's attack as well as the magical books that spawn from the bookery. You want a full inventory of these. That's the first thing I'm going to craft. I'm just going to make it to where I max out all this, and then lich has a very low chance of hitting me because the Act 4 boss, it spawns all the bosses, and then you go to the Act 4 boss. So if you're not strong enough to beat the lich because you're worried about putting lanterns down in villages and you haven't fought any real monsters, lich is going to blow you up. Unless you just reflect everything back, and then now you have a whole nother bar to play with, and that's going to be enough to where you can get the infinite loop set up. Pickaxes. These are massive. Plus one pebble when passing the campfire tile. Well, if you're doing an infinite loop, you're just going to get infinite rocks that way. So it's about just getting to that point, them being good to go. Also, the antique shelf, since we are prioritizing resources, eventually this just makes you ridiculous. So that's what we have right there. Everything else, I am just going to dismantle. Also, depending on where you are in the game, you might be wondering, well, cool, you got 3,000 wood, but how does that make it to where you've effectively beat the game? How do you have infinite resources when you have one metamorphosis? Like, apparently something failed there. Nah, you just got alchemy. So eventually you just make it to where you can decompose things, and then you can go and craft other things with it. So I effectively have infinite resources. It involves a lot of clicking. That's gonna be quite a lot of time spent here to get enough to do whatever I want, but that's the idea. So I think we're good right there. Yeah, you just want that supply, you want that deck. You can build up as much things you got. So let's get in it and let me show you guys how I got this one going. Now, when the map spawns, I'm looking for very specific patterns, and mostly what I'm looking for is 5 in a row before a corner, because that's going to play really nicely with road lanterns. I don't think I'm ever going to get as lucky as I did here. Like, that's a 1 in a million map, because as you can see, everything was just kind of lined up perfectly. That this takes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lanterns to take out 4 spaces, but then if you add these extra 3 right here, nothing is spawning on this horseshoe, and that's 7 spaces for 9 lanterns, which is almost as good as villages, and I think technically better, because that's 7 villages, which means you would need 3 oblivions on top of it to destroy the bandit camps. So it kind of depends on like what you have. So if you get a couple of these, that's really good. This cross shape, I think it's like 1 in a million, never happening again. But anything else that isn't going to be covered by lanterns, you want to put villages on the corners and stuff like that. Oh, and quick side note, I know that if I had more ruins, I would be getting more resources faster. Sometimes you just gotta take what you got. I decided to close the loop, not risk anything, not get any more cards, and not place too many ruins that were too risky as I went along. So those are some things. Your loop could look different. It could put out way more resources. If you get really good at this, or if you already have like a lot of really items, or you feel you're very proficient at the game and in-game and skilled and whatnot, place beacons as well. That way you just move around the loop faster. Or you could just AFK for 3 days and then come back and never have to worry. You're free to do whatever. I'm looking for some very specific stuff and just retreat. It's not worth it to try to salvage or build on a weird one, especially because it's so fast and there's like no penalty. That looks like hot garbage. Nah, like if there's too many corners, then it's going to take too many villages or too many road lanterns and it's not going to be efficient. If you get a suboptimal map, it can still be playable, and this actually looks pretty strong because we have a big horseshoe right here, and I believe that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. That's really good looking. And another thing to note is that when the Lich's Palace spawns, it actually takes up 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces where nothing will spawn after you beat the Lich, and even before you beat the Lich. So you don't have to worry about anything immediately near the campfire, and that can help out. So looks like it's still going to take a good amount of villages. We're going to pop this right here because that's in where the Lich is going to spawn. It's not going to really take up anything. And now we're just going to be looking for the lanterns. Oh. We want to stay for this one. This is not one to give up. I want to give it a shot, and we can just kind of keep on going. So with that perfect loop that I got, and then got the infinite set up, that was my 5th attempt, and most of those attempts didn't even have the mirrors, so I lost to the Lich a lot. So if you start stacking those, you start saving those resources, you're going to be good to go. I don't recommend putting up ruins until you have a couple of lanterns, because then you just get 4 spawns, they wreck you, and then you don't even kill them because the worms tunnel away. We're not running groves because that just means more dead draws. Spider cocoons are good though, but you need to pay attention to where you're putting everything. If I put a spider cocoon here, well, that's actually a big screw up because now I can't put a lantern there, so I need to oblivion the cocoon before I do anything. So as you can see, the pattern's going to build out. And that's about where you want it. And then you'll start putting ruins in this area, depending on how many lanterns you get and how that starts stacking up. I'm just already like still set on the reset method, but there we go. So bookery, gonna be high priority, lantern. Okay, so here's what I'm gonna show you guys. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's how you use 8 lanterns to take up 5 spaces, because this is gonna be overlapped by these corner ones. And that's why you could put monster spawns here, because if I drop this, I'm just gonna start it here. Well, now if I put another lantern here, only 2 spiders can spawn, very, very manageable. And then we can also put another one like around the corner or something, and that's going to be really good for the spider spawns as well. Also, if your first couple of loops go bad, don't feel bad about just restarting it, because it's going to be a lot less hassle if like something just becomes unsalvageable. Just restart, it only costs a couple minutes, go and do it again, then you're going to be good to go. So with this, boom, we put the road lantern right here, now that spawn is going to be fine. And then we can also start playing around the ruins, because what that does is it opens up the opportunity to put a ruin over here. And then as we get into our next lantern, we're going to be okay. So ruin here, never have ruins touching for monsters, especially in Act 4, because there's just too many passives and things just start getting way too scary on the damage. But then I want to put my next lantern here, and that means only one of these guys is spawning, two of these guys are spawning, and then we can start building out this, like, dead zone eventually. Haven't got any villages until just now. Really nice to have within Oblivion, but when you're playing these bookeries, you need to pay attention, because that's going to wipe out 9 cards really quick, so you want to make sure everything is okay. So, 2 dead zones, village here is probably fine. You just kind of just want to start to close the map with those dead zones. So, we got that. Really quickly want to check. We have a free Oblivion to use. It's like we can just blow up something if we needed to, like if I don't like where a spawn is or something bad is happening, because it's about to get recycled, but overall, that's okay. We'll get a ton more Oblivions. Spider cocoons. I'm like also just trying to think about the future. If we put a spider cocoon here, eventually it's going to have some overlap with the next road lamps we're putting up, and then maybe just to get some extra spawns, another one right here, because that's not going to have any lamps on it. So there we go. Now we see, this is what I mean, now this is where things start getting weird, because we didn't have our Oblivion, we have a village, we could take a risk and just like drop it and then hope we get an Oblivion soon, but I'm not banking on that too much. Again, you're just going to have so many cards at the end, that's okay. Putting this here means we won't have to waste anything because the village is going there anyways. And now we just kind of see what happens. And then we got one shot right here to get an Oblivion. So it is going to take some experience, it is going to take some feel, but eventually you're just going to get an idea of like, okay, if I do this and it doesn't screw me over, it's just going to kind of set up really well. Also, I've been screwing up. I've been worrying about too much on commentary, and I haven't been upgrading my weapons and armor, so I took a bit of unnecessary damage. Now we're stacked right there. We're getting into some good fights. We're getting a lot of cards right now, which is also really good. If you start getting too many dead draws or like nothing really comes through for you, that can be bad. And Oblivion would have been perfect there, but that's still okay. So now we can cap what's happening here. So that's going to be just fine for a good long amount of time. If we get another spider web, we can start putting it here. And then we're getting resources. That's looking good. I'm going to gamble on the village. It's not something that you want to do, but I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So I got 12 cards coming up, and that means I'm free to place this village. So let's hope an Oblivion is on the way. And other than that, I don't think I need to be setting up too much more at this time. Got a good amount of base monsters that are going to be spawning, and we just need to start stacking up stuff. So there we go. Risk paid off. Don't do that in the late game. I've had it to where I was like 2 blocks away from a perfect loop. I gambled on the bandit camp, and the bandit camp ended up killing me like a couple turns later. So I considered putting another spider cocoon there. If that gets out of control, then we might need to Oblivion it, because if too many spiders spawn there, which they will, so I'm already actually regretting this decision, because you don't want to get too greedy. I want to get all the cards, and I want to get this set up, and I don't want to fall behind. But honestly, with that last loop, I did it with like 3 spider webs max and a couple of ruins that gave me good drops. Because now, when that bookery expires, which will be very soon, we're going to have a book and a lot of spiders to deal with. Can pay off if we get lucky, can kill us if we're really unlucky, so thing to consider right there. Might want to start putting some villages on these corners so I have intermediate healing throughout. And that's just kind of how you want to get the thing set up. Also, quests. Quests are double-edged swords. They could screw me over if I have a quest spider that I can't kill and then a book goes and destroys me. But at the time, it's all right. Okay, we got another road lantern. I don't want to put that here because then that kills the ruins. That's a potential dead spawn now. I want to put it here, and then I want to put another one here, and then that limits that spider to 2, and then we're good. And then we can start putting in road lanterns in other spots, and then we can start controlling the rest of the map. We're not getting any quest items yet, but when those start coming in, that can also help snowball us to keep us alive through some of this insanity. Dead draws, another bookery. Again, you don't want to put a bookery where you're going to have lanterns, or else that could be a really bad Oblivion position. So let's put that here. Shouldn't get in the way of any spawns. Next Oblivion, I might just get rid of that, though. Or, yeah, I'll get rid of that, and then we'll see what happens. Okay, so we got an Oblivion. Yeah, that I think that spider's nest is just way too much. So we got three monsters there. That's fine. That's manageable. We got a bookery coming up, so that could be another Oblivion, so I could get these villages down. And not the end of the world. Alright, so yeah, now you just kind of get some loops going. As you noticed in the last one, I didn't put down rivers or meadows too much. You can if you have a lot of mirrors, because you're going to be fighting the Lich anyways. So if I drop these, it kind of loses some bookery refreshes, but it means we are going to be healthier in the long run. So now extra 22 health per day as a rogue or as a magic shield user, it's good. So as we just kind of do laps and pass camp and pass villages and stuff, we will be getting a lot of much needed health back. And as you can see, like, three spiders. Kind of tricky right now. That was four plus magic book. We dead. Also, like I said, the mirrors can be really good if you're using them to, like, counter books. So, depending on, like, what you spawn next to a bookery, it can be very strong, because that boy just gives us tons of cards. But it can be risky, so I need to do a lot of crafting to make a better setup, but I don't think I ever need to do an infinite loop again. So it kind of depends on your game state to what you're going to get away with. Card sharp. There we go. We don't need Marauder until later, potentially, for, like, the extra trophies to stay strong in those later parts. Surveyor, pfft, sure, whatever. Even though we're getting a lot of health from the lanterns at that point, preserving cards is actually incredible at this state. So, like, I went to Oblivion that, put the bookery there. We're still good. My philosophy is you can really never have too many bookeries, and we just got it back. So, like, dang. Guess we put another one there. And I think that's pretty much going to be it. You want to play a light card farming loop. You don't want to put down too much stuff to spawn enemies too soon, or like spawn the bosses too soon. You just want to keep up with the game, and then eventually everything is going to have, yeah, so now we put a village here. That corner's taken care of. That bandit camp gets nuked immediately. We didn't get that card back. That's still okay. We have a lot of bookeries coming up, and yeah, all of this is going to be lanterns. All of this is going to be lanterns. I'm going to build out villages here forever, and then we'll see how many of this is lanterns versus village. Like, I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and that eats up these four, so 6 for 4, and then we go village, 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 and then we're done. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope it's going to get you on your first steps to infinite loops and infinite resources and eventually beating the game and feeling like a complete baller. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like, share with your friends, comment down below, tell me your thoughts, tell me what else you want to see about the game or how I'm handling Loop Hero content. I hope you guys have a nice day. Thank you very much for watching.